helpful with helping me learn about Earth.
Hi, I'm Robin the Robot, and I'm thrilled to meet you.
Robin provides a near-human experience at a time where we're limited in having these relationships and these companionships, particularly in the hospital.
Robin gives children a way to completely be themselves and a way to have control and power. The hospital being a place where children don't have a lot of control, they don't have a lot of power or autonomy, and Robin gives that back to them. Children get to be the experts around Robin, right? Robin is this innocent being that's learning about the world, and children get to be Robin's teacher.
I come from outer space.
Really?
What planet are you from?
Earth.
You're an Earth blue. Wait a minute. I think I might know what Earth looks like. Let me check my database. Is this Earth?
Well, that's Earth.
We're in the same planet as you are.
Robin has the unique ability to engage almost a person as a companion. Robin has an onboard software algorithm that allows it to perform a real-time analysis of the video that it receives through its eye cameras of facial expressions of the kids that it's interacting with. So Robin knows if a child is happy, sad, angry, anxious, and can quantify that so that ultimately whoever's controlling Robin can teach Robin and hand over the reins. Down the line, we're thinking in the order of a couple of years, Robin ought to be autonomous to be able to carry out a conversation and provide emotional support without a controller.
My favorite thing to do is bring smiles and fun to pediatric patients.
We learned about Robin the Robot prior to the COVID pandemic, and we're excited about having it here at UCLA to help with taking care of the children that are hospitalized.
So when Robin was first introduced to the patients, there was immediate excitement. When we brought the robot to patient rooms to sort of experience that interaction, it was just electric.
There was one little girl who was sort of one of our first patients that we were trying Robin out with, and she absolutely fell in love with Robin. This little girl asked for Robin all the time. Every time we would walk down the hallway, she would poke her head out the door and say, "Can I see Robin today?" And she just wanted to talk. She didn't need all these games or big fun activities. She just wanted to talk, and she just wanted a companion, and she ended up inviting Robin to her birthday party. Which was here, and was super excited when Robin came to her birthday party.
We've really been seeing, along with the subjective, we're also seeing some of the medical and clinical benefits in terms of patients eating more, participating in activities, getting out of bed, and doing the things that we'd like to see them do so that they recover quicker and are able to go back to their usual activities as soon as possible.
You know, we're most moved by children who are in the hospital who need a companion, but I think Robin just has the opportunity to touch lives that are across the entire spectrum of age. And isolation is not a feeling that's limited to children in the hospital. I think Robin will be a really useful adjunct to the clinical care we can provide by giving some companionship to any patient.
There are literally limitless boundaries with regards to how this technology can be applied, particularly the elderly, who are also socially vulnerable and can benefit from the companionship that we are now studying through Robin here at UCLA.
Play is important to human children and robots too. I looked up my Earth database, and as great Albert Einstein would say, play is the highest form of research. Thanks for letting me play today.